It's very easy to analyze data with generative AI. Today, I'll show you how to use agents for data analysis. Here is the app we built. This app helps us perform your data analysis. To use this app, first, we'll upload a dataset in CSV format. After that, we'll enter a prompt to talk to this file, and our app will return a response. This is nice, right? To build this app, we leverage LangChain and Streamlit. The model we'll use is a Haiku model, a Claude 3 model. This model is fast and cheap. Nice! We've seen the app we built. Now, let's take a look at the topics we cover. First, we create a visual environment and install tools. Next, we'll initialize the app with Streamlit. After that, we'll use create CSV agent. We'll pass the Haiku model to this agent. Lastly, we'll build the frontend of the app to return the output. Awesome! We've seen the topics we'll handle. At the end of the video, you will see that generative AI is a game changer in data analysis. Let's dive in. To write our code, let me open the VS Code editor. What we're gonna do now is create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use conda. Let's write conda create dash n, let's name gen AI. I already created this. After that, we're gonna activate this environment. Conda activate gen AI. Here you go. Our environment is ready to use. The next step we're gonna do is install the tools we use. To do this, let's create a requirement.txt file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. After that, let's write the libraries we use here. We're gonna type LangChain. After that, let's write LangChain experimental to use the agent. And then let's type LangChain Anthropic for the model. For building the front end of the app, we're gonna use Streamlit. For now, these tools are enough to build the app. We're gonna now install this. To do this, let's use pip. Pip install -r requirements.txt. Here you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our code, we're gonna create a Python file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name app.py. Yeah, our file is ready. So far, we created a visual environment. Let's go ahead and initialize the app with Streamlit. Streamlit allows you to build web apps. First in first, let's import Streamlit. Import Streamlit as st. Next, let's set the page config. st.setPageConfig. Let's set the page title parameter talk to your CSV. After that, st.header, let's pass talk to your CSV. Nice! We've created our titles. Now, let's open this app in the browser. It's simple to do this. Let's go to the terminal and then write streamlit run app.py. Voila! Easy peasy, right? Here, you can see the title of our app. Let's go ahead and create a file uploader widget. For this, we're gonna use the file uploader method. Let's say CSV file equals st.fileuploader. Let's set upload a CSV file. Let's give the type of the file format. Type equals CSV. Okay, our widget is ready. Let's take a look at how it works. Let me click over here and then select the file. As you can see, we've uploaded our dataset. This dataset contains the populations of the countries. Note that this file is in the CSV format. Let's go ahead and create our agent. Agents are amazing systems that use LLMs to select a series of actions to take. You can utilize them for question answering, RAG, data analysis, etc. The agent we're gonna use is the CSV agent. This agent allows you to interact with data in CSV format. It's important to note that this agent calls the pandas data frame agent under the hood. Okay, let's import this agent. from LangChain experimental dot agents toolkit import create CSV agent. If CSV file is not none, we're gonna initialize our agent. If CSV file is not none, let's create the agent. Let's say agent equals create CSV agent. The first parameter we're gonna set is the model. We're gonna use a Claude 3 model. Let's say Haiku. This model is fast and cheap. To use this model, let's import the chat entropic class. Let's write from LangChain entropic import chat entropic. Next, let's initialize an object from this class. Chat entropic. Let's first set the model. Model name equals. Let's set the name. Claude3 Haiku. Let me set numbers. Next, let's pass our file. CSV file. Next, let's set the variable parameter to true. Verbos equals true. Lastly, let's set the agent type. To do this, we're gonna use the agent type class. Let's import this. From LangChain agents agent types import agent type. Next, let's set agent type equals agent type. Let's call zero shot react description. Nice, our agent is ready. Now, to get an input from the user, let's create a text input field in our app. To do this, we're gonna use the text input method. Let's write user question equals, it's gonna be sd.textInput. Let's pass a text. Ask a question about your CSV. Now, if user question is none and not empty, we're gonna want the agent to return a response. If user question is not none and user question not empty, let's want to display a message while running a block of code. To do this, we can leverage the spinner method with sd.spinner. Let's set text equals in progress. After that, let's run our agent. Response equals agent. Let's call the invoke method. Let's pass user question. Lastly, let's print the response. sd.write response. Let's pass output. Lastly, to set the entropic API key, let's use the .envim tool. To do this, let me create an env file and then let's write entropic API key. All we need to do, paste the API key here. Okay, let's get this API key here. To do this, from .env import load.env. Next, let's use this method load.env. Cool, our app is ready for data analysis. It's time to test our app. Go to our app. Let me click rerun. Here you go, our app is ready. First, let's upload our file. As you can see, the text input field has appeared. Let's talk to dataset. We're gonna start with a simple question. Which countries have more than 1 billion population? Let me press enter. Oops, we got an error. Let me fix this. We wrote the name wrongly. Let me fix this. Cloud. After that, let's go to the app and then click rerun. Voila! Here you can see the response. Let's go ahead and ask another question. How many rows are there? As you can see, the number of the rows is printed. This way, you can ask any question you want about the dataset. This is awesome, right? Let's say you wanna draw a bar plot of the top 5 countries by population. Just tell this to the agent. Let me show you. Let's say, write code to draw a bar plot of top 5 countries by population. Here you go. You can use this code to create a bar plot with the top 5 countries. This is cool, right? Yeah, that's it. In this video, we covered how to use a LangChain agent for data analysis. To talk to the dataset, we built an app with Streamlit. This app is not bad for data analysis. Note that the link to this notebook is in the description. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.